Jeff Morrow back here in between the second and third period of the Sarah Catholic Somerset 3-1 in favor of Sarah Catholic. We have a very special guest with us, Ed Ritty III, coach of Radnor, and the defending single-A state champions. Won your third. Congratulations, coach.
Thank you.
Third Flyers Cup in a row.
Yeah.
Made the long trek out here with his longtime assistant, Dave Cook, right?
Dave Wood.
I apologize. Dave Wood is along with us, and the guys emailed us the other day, told us they were coming in. We figured we'd get a word with them. How'd the season go this year, Coach?
Good, good. We had a lot more adversity than we have had in the past, but I think it's led to us battling through a much tougher Flyers Cup than the past three seasons.
Well, we were hoping that Chris Brennan and Eddie Devine were going to come over with us. They're the two big guns for Radnor. You know, you guys have stepped it up in the middle of your lineup. Nick Ryder's had a good season for you, and your goaltending's improved. But let's forget about all that stuff. We all know about Radnor. You guys are, obviously, I think you're the favorites to win it all. But you could face a Sarah team that you faced 2 years ago. It could be interesting.
Yeah. That's something that everyone would like to see. Sarah, us, some of the fans, you. So I hope whoever comes out of here is ready to go, because I know we are.
Well, you see, he went to the Joe Paterno School of Coaching, and he's you know, and I think Jeff Nolan or Matt Sachs might have helped this guy out. But, you know, it's interesting. Hockey in the state now has become pretty interesting. We now know what's going on both sides of the state. You and I got the chance to sit down at the state dinner last year. And for people that don't know, Ed's father, Ed Ritty, Jr. And he started the Malvern Prep program, and Malvern's having a great year. But it's starting to get better, the coaching, the scouting. I think it's tremendous here. You're here at the Mellon Arena. What's your impressions of the game today?
It's both teams are very well coached. I mean, that's obvious. They know where they're supposed to be and what the plan is. They're both very patient. They're both, I think, extremely hardworking. And right now, I think they're both pretty tired.
Timmy Johnson, though, there's a guy that you know a little bit about.
All too well.
Yeah.
All too well.
You know, this is an interesting thing. You know, I haven't had the chance to, but I'm hoping to next year take a ride out and see all three Flyers Cup games. This setup's a little different than you guys do it out there. Mm-hmm. The way they set it up is that the Flyers Cup single A, double A, and triple A are on separate nights. Of course, you defeated Lower Dauphin in the Flyers Cup final. Ran into a little bit of a roadblock, a hot goaltender, Chris Coleman for Lower Dauphin. It was a tight game for a while there.
Yeah, he's just a fantastic freshman. And they ran, again, a very disciplined, well-run trap, which we had to adjust to a little bit. And once we adjusted, we got some shots in some dangerous areas, and that capitalized for it.
One thing I wanted to ask you, and we're going to step away from the game and the state. The Flyers Cup committee now starting to move more towards classification. Mm-hmm. We're starting to see true single A, double A, triple A out there. How's that been recepted out there?
I think it leads to a more competitive Flyers Cup. We know, you know who you're going to see in the Flyers Cup if you do make it there. It's mixed signals, but as with any change, I think it's going to be mixed signals for a little bit, but I think it will work out for the most part, and it reflects a little bit more of what happens out here.
Yeah, and they've, as a lot of people know, we've been together here in AAA, AA, and single A for the last 5 years, and it's really worked wonders, and I think we're starting to see the teams come back and forth. You said you don't travel. We'd love to see you come out to Western Pennsylvania. But you're a small team,
yes.
small school.
Yes.
And you do have a lot of club players. We do know that Brennan and Devine do play for a club team. So it's a little tough adjusting the schedule. We want to wish you luck next week, or 2 weeks.
Two weeks.
We're going to be at Neville Island, and we're going to get to reacquainted with some of our friends from Philadelphia. Ed Ritty III, always a pleasure to see you. We want to wish you the best
Thanks
of luck in the state finals.
Thanks.
And Sarah or Somerset will meet Ed's team, and we're looking forward to it. Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
I didn't ask too many. Jeff Morrow, Al Pulaski back here at the Mellon Arena. Sarah Catholic in front of Somerset 3-1 after two periods. Al, let's talk about those keys for Somerset real quickly here.
Well, one big key is going to be to maximize Brett Ziegler's time on the ice. They've got to get him out there if they need to double shift him, shift and a half. You know, they need him on the ice because he's going to be the guy that's going to do something for them.
Okay, big battle along the boards there. There's Tony Duco in a big collision there with Colin Eddy. Ziegler up with it. Ziegler moves it along over to Colin Eddy, and Eddie's just going to drive it into the Sarah zone. Here's Roush down behind the net, moves it to the front of the net. And a good play there by Josh Jones to keep it out. Taken away by Gruhalla. Gruhalla is just going to haul it up into the Somerset zone on a turning clock here with 14:27 remaining. Eddie, or Roush, is going to move it along. Josh Jones can't find it at his feet. And then we're going to have an offside call. Now, Sarah's, on the other hand, they've been here before, the end of the second period. We saw them last year and characteristically lose to Westmont.
Well, I think, you know, they got into a situation where Westmont was playing the more patient game, and Sarah found themselves pushing to get that go-ahead goal when it ended up backfiring on them, giving Westmont some opportunities they may not have had.
Okay, puck moved up into center ice, and Colby's going to be back there for Sarah. Timmy Johnson sets it up for him. Colby's just going to move it up off the boards and out to center ice. Here's Gillis with it. Gets behind the Somerset deepman. Gillis walks to the net, takes a wrist shot. Good save by Davey Dreeman. Oh, he just missed. Joey Manning missed the hat trick. Puck goes into the corner. Manning up with it. Moves it back to the point to Colby. Colby takes a drive. Oh, and it just went wide. Sarah looking for that killer goal. Out in front. Oh, and Gillis just missed. A couple of great chances there for Sarah Catholic to take a 4-1 lead. Noon up with it.
Sarah's going for the kill right now. You can see they want to try to put this thing away right now.
Okay. Lubash moves it into the zone. He's just going to clear it down there, and Wes Kramer's going to get that puck. Davies up with it. Davies moves the puck up along. Met there. Nice play by Duco. Duco's had a strong game here for Sarah Catholic. Boy, Boy's going to clear it up off the boards, and Hay has it. Hay up over center ice. He's going to clear it into the zone, and we're going to have an icing call. A little bit of a mistake there by Hay. You got to get it up over the red.
Yeah, and didn't seem like you should have any problem gaining the red line, but, you know, just a mistake, a little bit nervous and got rid of it too early.
Maybe not having not been here before, maybe a little jittery.
Yeah, I think that's going to show in this period probably more than even in the first period. I think it's going to be a matter of experience in the third period. It's going to keep teams from making some simple mistakes like that.
Okay, puck cleared around the boards. Not out of the zone. Good play by Josh Jones to keep it in. Puck move up along. And Colby's just going to hold that blue line. Duco up with it. Duco. Puck moves along, and Brett Ziegler's going to grab it there for Somerset. He looks the ice over. Moves it up ahead to Roush. Roush is going to drive it deep into the Sarah end. Good play by Eddy to keep it in. Roush is going to try to beat Duco to the puck, and he does. Good play by Duco to tie him up. They're tying up the puck along the boards. Here's Brett Ziegler up with it. Moves it to the net. Oh, and a good play there by Gruhalla as he stepped down and played some good defense. Good work by Gruhalla. He clears it up the length of the ice.
Yeah, he's a real grinder. I mean, he just seems to do the little things, and, you know, every team needs, you know, those players that do the little things, you know, reminiscent of Phil Bork, you know, with the Penguins during their cup years.
Okay, faceoff's going to be to the left of Timmy Johnson. We have the big line with Manning, Lubash, and Gillis. Going to go against Ziegler, Eddie, and Roush. 12:23 remaining in regulation time. Puck moved back to the point. Davies going to move it along the board. Good play there by Lubash. He forces a bad errant pass. Lubash ties up the man. Here's Manning. Manning moves it to Gillis. Oh, and a good defensive play by Davies. Somerset watching that clock go away. 12:06 remaining here. Puck moves along. Here's a one-on-one chance. Colin Eddy. Moves to the net. Oh, and it just shot it wide. Lubash just going to clear it up out of the zone to Gillis. Good play there by Lubash. Billy Hoffman moves the puck along, and we're going to have an icing call. Good work there by Justin Lubash. He just really worked hard to get the puck out of the zone.
Yeah, and a little bit of a mistake on the part of Brett Ziegler. You know, he, instead of stopping in the slot right there, overskated the net, I'm sure with a little help from Sarah player, but you know, it's possible that centering pass you know, might have been able to hit his stick if he stops in front.
Okay, face off to the left of Wes Kramer. Hay steps in against Manning. Boy up with it, and we have a whistle there. Looks like an offside play. Sarah is won the Penguin Cup. They won it in 2000, 2001, 2002. Had a little break last year, and they're looking to capture their fourth and fifth year, 5 years here.
Well, I think I said, last year, yeah, they might have been sidetracked, but I think, a lot of people expected them to be back here this year, and sure enough, here they are, and, they're only about 11 minutes, 39 seconds away from going to another state final.
Okay, here's Chad Pritz, and Pritz gains the red and dumps it in. Jordan Woy is going to chase it down, but a good play by Gillis, clear the zone. Pritz keeps it in, nice play by Pritz. But there's Colby. Colby just clears it along over to Manning. And whenever you think you need a good defensive play, Colby's been there today. Here's Pritz up with it with his own end. 11-16 remaining here in regulation time. Big hit along the boards there. Here comes DiLoreto up over the line. He dumps it away into the Sarah zone. Hay trying to get back there, and he fell down inadvertently. Good play by Pritz to keep it into Woy. Woy moves it to DiLoreto. Back to the point. Park shoots it to the net. Good save by Timmy Johnson. And there's going to be a penalty coming up here. Here's a pull shot to the net. Good save by Timmy Johnson. And Manning's going to touch it up. And we're going to have an elbowing call here with 10:48 remaining out.
Yeah, I mean, it looked like the puck was there. And, that was a hit that he needed to make to clear the front of the net. But obviously, he threw the elbow in, and that's why the penalty was called.
And the Somerset fans are making some noise now. This may be a big, big point of the hockey game out.
To me, I think this is it right here. I mean, I'll go out on a limb and say if they don't score right here, their chances are done.
Okay, you've heard it. The prognostication of Al Pawlowski here. He's like the soothsayer. Back to the point. Here's Roush with it. You got Roush, Ziegler, Davies, Hoffman. Hoffman to the front of the net. Oh, and a good save by Johnson. He just got his stick on that. Cominetti. A lot of perimeter work here by Somerset, but they got to move that puck to the front of the net. Here's Eddie. Moves it to the front. Great play by Gruhala as he stepped down and intercepted that pass out.
Yeah, I mean, Somerset's spreading the ice out, when they're setting up for the power play here. But again, they don't have anyone in front. I think they need to get somebody in front to tie up the defenseman to take Timmy Johnson's concentration away a little bit and get an opportunity.
Okay. Good play by Noon. And he ties up Hay. Hay gets that puck. Good play by Hay. But Lubash steps in, and Josh Jones is going to get it, and he's going to drive it the length of the ice. 1:09 remaining here in the penalty. 9:55 remaining in regulation time. Here's Billy Hoffman up with it for Somerset. Hoffman going to move it along. Better play there. Good work by Justin Lubash. Lubash is a pest down there. Here's Roush up with it. He's going to move it along the center. Intercepted by Gillis. Take the big drive. Oh, and a good save by Kramer. Good work by Justin Lubash.
Yeah, he's a one-man wrecking crew down there. He tied up, two of the power play personnel for Somerset. And, that's all you're trying to do is just eat time up and slow down the play as much as you can until you can get back to even.
Okay, faceoff's going to come to left of Wes Kramer. This is a big power play chance for Somerset. They haven't been able to get on track. Great penalty killing there by Gillis and Justin Lubash.
Yeah, they're really stepping up. I think Sarah realized this is a turning point right now, too, and they realize they need the kill, and if they make the kill, they might have the game wrapped up.
Okay. Here comes up over the line. This is Park. Park's going to move it down behind the Sarah net, but Brian Noon steps there, the all-star defenseman. He just had another strong game here again this afternoon. Lubash going to step in beside. Hay up with it. Hay. Tries to buy time for his teammates. Great poke check by Josh Jones. And Lubach's going to clear it up off the boards. A great play by Gillis. Good teamwork by Sarah as they move the puck up. 14 seconds remaining and 9 minutes in regulation. Sarah sets it up behind their own net, or Somerset. Woy, Jordan Woy up with it for Somerset. He moves it along slowly. He's going to try to move that puck. He moves it along to Brett Ziegler. Brett Ziegler down over, takes a big shot. And Sarah's done a real effective job on Brett Ziegler today, and he has not tickled the twine as they have shut down the big line from Somerset. Here's Park. Park just moves it along into the Sarah zone, and we're back to even strength, 8.5 left. Great penalty-killing effort there by the Sarah Eagles. Good work by Grahala, and Duco just steps in there, and a nice play, and we're going to have an offside. They've shut that big line down now.
Well, I think, obviously Sarah knows that that's the line that was going to hurt them, and that's the line they really had to concentrate on and focus on. I think they did it physically in the first period. It just seems right now that, you know, they're out skating them a little bit. But, you know, I think Sarah, they've used that formula before, as I had mentioned, when they played a high-scoring Freeport team and Nick DeCru, who was one of the top players in the area. They shut their top line down and were able to win that game, which might have been their closest game that year.
Okay, Manning back 2-on-2. Manning walks to the line, and we're going to have an offside call. Hats off. Tony Duco, Steve Grahala, Filip Ivkovic. They're doing the job today. They haven't been on the board, but they've shut down that line effect.
Well, yeah, I think there wasn't their job today to score goals. It was just to, you know, neutralize that first line for Somerset and then let their top line come on and do the scoring.
Okay. 8:05 remaining, and the clock's coming in the favor of Sarah and the enemy of Somerset right now. 3-1 in favor of Sarah. Here's Gillis. Gillis with that puck. Good, moves it to the net. Only just shot it wide. Here's Colinetti up with it. Colinetti moves it to Ziegler. Ziegler in over the line. Ziegler shoots it to the net. Good save by Timmy Johnson. In front. Here's Eddie. Eddie shoots it to the net. Eddie. Oh, and it's blocked. Great block there by Josh Jones. Billy Hoppin will keep it in. Fred Ziegler down there. He's going to get there first. Good play to keep the puck up to the net. Good save by Johnson. Here's Davies. Davies over to Billy Hoppin. Billy Hoppin makes a move. Shoots it to the net. Oh, and a good save by Johnson as he went down and made the save. Hoppin keeps it in. Good play by Somerset. Kept in by Hoppin again. Hoppin's going to move that puck to Ziegler. Oh, and he just missed. Ziegler back to the point to Davies. All Somerset right now. And Johnson's going to tip it up into the crowd. Great sequence there for Somerset. And they just had a chance, but Sarah survived.
Goaltending. I mean, they have that 11-shot advantage here, the Somerset Eagles. But, you know, when they're getting their good opportunities, Timmy Johnson's just coming up bigger than the shots.
And that's what we've seen that before. And I think Ed Ritty, the third up here from Radnor, he's probably shaking his head because he's going to be seeing this in a couple weeks if Sarah comes out.
Yeah, they're at this point, they look like the team they'll be facing. And, you know, obviously cracking the code to Tim Johnson will be a key for their team.
Well, we don't want to get too far ahead of ourselves, but Sarah's look good things in hand. They're playing smart hockey. What they need to do now is they need to get the puck into the Somerset zone. But Somerset's applied some good pressure here. They're going to need a big goal out of this DiLoreto and Hay and Woy line here to get back in this game, in my opinion. Okay, there's Ivkovic. He keeps it, throws it to the net. Oh, and Kramer had to be short.
There's Grahala again. I mean, he made that play happen just by some, you know, very tenacious forechecking. You know, he caused them to give a turnover and give him a shot opportunity in the zone. So 44 for Sarah's doing a lot of good things out there, a lot of small things that are, you know, giving their team a lot of chances.
Okay, 6:56 remaining here. Sarah Catholic in front 3-1. Jeff Morrow, along with Al Pulaski and the super techno, Mr. Doug Heck, providing all the color for us. Here's Lubash up with it, gives it to Gillis. Gillis walks to the net, takes a backhander. Good save by Kramer, and Gillis is all over this team. Gillis just working that puck down in the corners with Lubash. Gillis and Lubash digging in deep. Here's Ziegler. Ziegler moves it along. Good back checking by Joey Manning. Manning up with it. And Ziegler's going to try to grab that puck in his own end. Here comes Gillis. Gillis grabs the puck. Gillis going to move it over to Manning. Manning on his wallet trying to move that puck, but he can't get it. Here's Lubash in front. Here's Davies. Davies up with it. And Somerset looks real tired right now. Expended a lot of energy here. Roush up with it for Somerset. Going to move the puck into the zone, and Billy Colby looks fresh out there. He's played probably 35 minutes today. Here's Ziegler. Ziegler walks to the net, makes a little move. Oh, and a good chance. But Timmy Johnson reached out to poke it away, and Duco's going to clear it up off the boards. Here's Duco up with it. He just moves it up the center to Lubash. Good work by Tony Duco back there. Okay, Davies going to move it up along. Ivkovic, good play there by Sarah just to break it up. And Ivkovic is going to get the puck, and he's just going to clear it up into the Somerset bench. Tony Duco playing smart back. He's playing back in that third guy high. Really knows the Sarah system. There's a kid that didn't play him a whole lot the last couple years, but he's really learned the system, and he's been very effective.
And I'm sure that's what he's being told by the bench. You know, go out there, be the high forward, you know, make sure we don't give him the odd man breaks. You know, again, they got the two-goal lead. They don't need to make anything to happen. Somerset. You know, at this point in time, you know, all they have to do is keep Somerset off the board and, you know, not worry about creating anything. So,
well, Somerset here, you know, they're in a place where they haven't been a whole lot of this time here. They've only scored one goal today. They've been averaging 9 a game. They're playing against a pretty good defensive team.
Yeah, I think definitely, you know, they had a high-scoring season. But, you know, when you play a goaltender that is as hot as Timmy Johnson is, and also defensemen that play as solid as Sarah does, it's tough to score. I mean, I don't care how many goals you've scored during the regular season. You know, this is a totally different thing when you're facing a goaltender like Tim Johnson. I mean, 32 shots, he's only let one in.
Right, and then, you know, again, we can't say enough about Timmy Johnson. This is a senior now. He's been there before for Sarah, and he's just been a stalwart. Outstanding goaltending today again, and he's made the saves, made the big saves when they need it.
Well, I'm sure he really wants his bat as a senior. You know, he wants to go to the state finals. He wants the state cup again.
And I think he can taste it now. And, you know, the funny thing is, when Sarah knows they have the game, Timmy Johnson will do a little lap. Let's see if he does it here and bang his stick on the ice. And that's when Timmy Johnson knows that he has the game.
Okay, is that kind of like the groundhog in Punxsutawney?
I'm not sure, but he did it the last game. But he does it periodically. When Sarah gets the game in hand and they know they have it, he'll take a little lap and he'll bang his stick.
Well, we'll
and they
watch
know.
For that.
Okay. Okay, here's Davies up with it. And we don't want to get too ahead of ourselves. Bad icing. We don't want to get ahead of ourselves, but, you know, Sarah has this thing under control, and they're going to do the smart thing.
Yeah, I think, you know, the only thing that they can do wrong now is maybe to try to step up and take some chances that is going to turn around and give Somerset some odd man breaks. So if they're disciplined, you know, they have it pretty well under control right now.
Okay, and as we see, Lubash just steps around, and he's just going to clear the puck down behind the net. And I'm sure Tom Mooney. Okay, here's Gillis. Gillis walks to the net, takes a first shot. Oh, and it just missed. Good hustle there by Ray Gillis. Puck cleared along. It looks like we're going to have an icing call. And Sarah will take these all day, Al.
That's just, you know, the clock is their friend right now. And so the more time that ticks off of it, the better for Sarah.
Okay, 5:04 remaining here. Shots are 32-22 in favor of Somerset. But the big score on the board is 3 for Sarah and 1 for Somerset. Brett Ziegler is going to step in here against his nemesis today, Tony Duco. And Duco's just been had a great unsung game here for Sarah Catholic. Puck, big battle along the boards. Brett Ziegler's going to step in there. And one thing Somerset could ill afford to do is take a penalty right now. Here's Davies. Davies going to clear it up off the boards. Good play there by Colin Eddy, but a better play by Josh Jones. As Billy Hoffman steps in. Here's Davies up with it. Davies going to get up over the center line. He's just going to dump it away. Puck into the zone. Eddy can't get there. And there's big Bill Hoffman. But a good play by Josh Jones as he clears it the length of the ice. 4:27 remaining here in the third period. 3-1 Sarah, and we'll be right back. Okay, here's Josh Jones. He's going to clear it around the board. And up there, here's Matt Hay. Matt Hay, and Somerset's got to make something happen now here, Al. 4:15 remaining. Do the defensemen start pinching out?
Well, yeah, they need to hold the blue line and try to keep the puck in as much as possible. I mean, you know, we're to a point right now where, you know, time is an ally of Sarah, and they've got to maximize the opportunities to get shots.
Okay, play's going to move along here into the Somerset zone, but there's Colby, and he's just going to clear it back in. And it's like a broken record, Sarah Catholic. They just play very solid defensive hockey. Puck moves along. Prince is going to get there first for Somerset. Moves it up along the boards to Ziegler. Hey, going to chase it down. Josh Jones there gets there first for Sarah, and he's going to clear it around the boards and all the way out of the zone. 3:45 remaining here in regulation. Somerset has a big hill to climb right here. Lubash, just a big battle down there, and he's ragging that puck. Great play by Justin Lubash. He's been a strong player here in this game. Colby's going to get it, and he's just going to clear it off the boards into the Somerset zone. There's Roush, and Roush is going to clear it the length of the ice and didn't get up over the red line.
they're not gaining that red line. They're not getting an inch from the referees or the linesmen. So, you know, they have to make sure they gain that red line before they send it in deep. They can't afford to keep taking faceoffs in their own end and have to go up the length of the ice to get some opportunities. They don't have the time. They got to gain the red line, get it in deep, and put pressure on.
Well, and you know, Cliff Ziegler's complaining about it, but hey, you know, the rules are the rules. Cliff's the referee himself. You got to get that puck over the red line, and that's the way it is. Okay, here's Ivkovich. Ivkovich. Okay, Brett Ziegler, and he looks a little tired, but here's Roush up with it. As Somerset has been battered around here today. Here's Roush. He's just thrown against the board by Josh Jones. Ziegler's going to grab the puck, shoot it to the net. Oh, and a good tip by Eddie. Eddie battling down there with Ryan Noon for the puck. 2:57 remaining. Somerset's top line looks a little ragged here, Al. They don't have the jump they had early in the game.
No, definitely not. I think, you know, actually the entire game, they don't seem to be the same team they were against Quaker Valley. I mean, I think they were just flying and controlling, you know, that game. Their forwards were flying into the zone. And they've kind of been tentative all day. And, you know, maybe that's come back to hurt them.
Okay, and it may be a lot of the experience of being here before. You know, we talked about this in the outset. Sarah's been here before. They've been the team that has played in this game many years, and these kids came out and jumped on them early, and that's why Sarah won the hockey game, or is winning the hockey game, but could go on to win.
Well, you know, the big difference, you know, they got a two-goal lead early, and that's what the lead is right now. So that's the difference in the game, was just that first period where they were able to jump up 2-0.
Okay, puck back to the point. Here's Billy Hoffman. Hoffman moves it to the net. Couldn't get a tip on it. Roush and Timmy Johnson just swipes it aside. Here comes Manning up with it. And a big hit along the boards, but Davies is going to get it. Here comes Davies. He's going to rush it over the line. An offside call. Looked like Matt Roush was on the right wing. He's offside. And maybe mentally now, Somerset's starting to get a little drained.
Well, you know, they're anxious to get to the net. They're anxious to jump the zone. But, you know, every time you take that offside, you're just killing a scoring chance.
Okay. Sarah fans are whooping it up. They know that the Sarah's 2.5 away, and they're just going to watch it, and they just clear it back to center. Here's Davey up with it. Davey moves along the boards. Roush taken there by Eddie, but a good defensive play there by Ryan Noon. Here comes Roush, and Noon's just going to clear it to the corner. Good play by Roush. Tries to tie up the play, but Justin Lubash steps in the middle of it, and he's going to get the puck out of the zone. Stolen there by Ziegler. Ziegler goes to the net. Oh, and a good defensive play there by Ryan Noon as he tied up Brett Ziegler. Excellent defensive work by Sarah Catholic. Here's Sarah. They're going to clear it up, and Hoffman up with it. And Sarah just will not back off. They are playing just tenacious hockey right now.
There's no quit in them, that's for sure. And, you know, they realize they just got to skate hard here for another minute 45, and they're going to be in another state final.
Okay, here comes Colinetti up over the line. Going to make that move. Takes a walk to the net. Shoots it. No, he holds it. Holds it again. Colinetti up with it. Tries to make a move, but it's broken up there by Joey Manning. Manning just going to get up to the line, and he's going to dump it away.
Hey, at this point, Somerset has to get everything to the net that they possibly can. And right there, you know, that was a lost chance because skating behind the net, they didn't even end up with a shot on goal. Looks like we have some type of penalty call here.
And who's Dave Donatelli whistling off? He's going to, and there with a minute, that's a death nail there. It's Colinetti's going to go to the ball.
Well, I mean, at this point even takes the opportunity of maybe pulling your goaltender and trying to get back in the game that way out the door. So,
well, so let's hand it to Sarah Catholic here, Al. Sarah Catholic knew what they wanted to do coming into this game. They grabbed the lead. They played smart. They moved the puck deep. And then they relied on their man, Timmy Johnson.
Yeah, I mean, a great game plan. I mean, they obviously matched that second line up against Somerset's first line. They played a physical game, and, you know, then they rely on Timmy Johnson. I think, you know, they realize with him as a goaltender, they can maybe take a few more chances, do a few more things than other teams might be able to.
Okay, Sarah Catholic, a minute 6 away from going to their fourth Penguin Cup title in 5 years. Ryan Noon's going to get that puck. And Somerset looks a little disinterested right now. And Sarah's just going to hold that puck behind their net. This is just classic Sarah Catholic hockey. Gillis is going to move it up. Prince is going to get there. Moves it up to Hay. But it's Josh Jones back there. 40 seconds. We're down to 40. Good play. Gillis is going to grab it in his own end. Gillis up with it. He's going to move it along. Here's Lubash. Lubash, it'll go. He shoots. Oh, and a great save by Kramer. I don't think it's going to matter. We're down to 25. Sarah Catholic looks like they're on their way to the Penguin Cup in 2004. Gillis going to step in. And Sarah just has three guys back, and they're playing smart hockey. Lubash shoots it to the net. It looks like Sarah Catholic's going to be on their way. We're down to eight. Josh Jones is going to take it back in his own zone. Josh Jones has the puck. We're down to two. It's Sarah Catholic. It's going to be the 2004 Penguin Cup champion. And there's bedlam down there, but the referees do a good job stepping in between them. And they did a great job there, a great job by the refs. But Sarah Catholic wins it. 2004 Penguin Cup champion.
Well, you know, I think it's great conversation on the part of the coaches, as well as just the execution. Obviously, the players have to execute the game plan, and they did it to a T. Very competitive game. And, Somerset has nothing to be ashamed of. I mean, they've had a great season, and they've lost to a real tough team here. They've lost to a team who has a very good chance of winning the state.
Okay, Sarah Catholic will move on against Radnor. You know, Somerset had a great season to get here. They have nothing to be ashamed of.
Well, yeah, as I said before, a great year for them. And, you know, it's obviously got to be a little bit disheartening. You can see it with a minute left to go. The wind was out of their sails at that point. But, they've got to look back and realize that, you know, what they've accomplished this year is something their program never has accomplished before, and that they need to, look back and look at the positive side of it and realize that Sarah Catholic is a team that's been here many times, and, you know, possibly they can come back next year and challenge for it again.
Okay, stars of this game, Timmy Johnson, 32 saves.
Yeah, I would think, he would, there'd be an argument for him definitely being the number one star. No one could argue against him getting that.
Well, we were here a year ago, and I'll tell you what, this line with Manning, Justin, Lubash, and Gillis was the second line for Sarah. And they were strong in that Westmont game. And really, today they showed here, that they are one of the top lines in Western Pennsylvania, if not the state.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, they basically were the checking line last year. They've moved up to be the number one line this year. And when you're talking about stars of the game, how about that second line for Sarah? Maybe that whole line deserves a star led by Gruhala, because they definitely, kept one of the highest, if not the highest scoring line in the league off the board.
Tony Duco, Steve Gruhala. Okay, those are the guys we're talking about. Outstanding game today by Sarah Catholic. And everybody all year said Sarah Catholic, they only have 12, 13 kids. It takes smart hockey.
Yeah, when you play smart hockey,
number five, Chad Pitts.
When you play smart hockey, you don't need a big team. Like I said, if you cover the ice the right way, you don't have to, skate that hard to win. I mean, I'm not saying they don't skate hard, but what I'm saying is they play smart. And, they're able to maximize what they have on that bench, a small 12, 13-man bench.
Okay, we're going to let go to the medals presentation. Doug Hex focusing in on that. Jeff Morrow, Al Pulaski, I want to thank you today.
11,
Doug Hex, great coverage. We're going to go to the medals presentation. Jeff Morrow signing off. Sarah Catholic is your 2004 Penguin Cup champions. We look forward to seeing you over at Neville Island in 2 weeks.
Both teams.
Number 14, Derek Ryan. Number 15, Alex Olsen. Number 22, Matthew Rauch. Number 34, William Hoffman. Number 37, Josh Barrett. Number 39, Wes Kramer. Number 43, Eric DiLoretto. Number 44, Chris Park. And number 47, Raymond Flower. And at this time, we invite head coach Cliff Ziegler and assistant coach Matt Gavrak to come forward and accept their individual awards. Congratulations to the Somerset Golden Eagles on a great season and a great playoff.
Forget about it, huh?